and as I look down here upon the safety winners, you made excellent choices again, but I do need to talk a little bit about safety, okay? This is our safety month, and we talk about it a little bit because all of our rules and everything we do are about, do you know what that's about? Why do we, Paris, why do we have all those rules? Because we like to make your life hard.
So we can stay safe.
The most important thing is when you send these kids to the school that they come home safe, and that is at the forefront of the entire staff. But you are very lucky because you have children who are very aware of that. And not only do they keep themselves safe, but they keep all of us safe and others safe. But here's the big thing I want to talk to you about as far as your kids who were the safety winners. It's an important one as a parent. So those of you who've had multiple kids, I've had two, one was safety conscious and the other one wasn't, okay? So maybe you have experienced that too, but let me tell you about the ones who are safety conscious. The scariest thing that we have as parents is, will they follow others when they know they shouldn't? Okay, and this is your safety winner because they think for themselves. They are not influenced by others. They know how important it is to stay safe. And I don't think they realize how important that is to us as parents. And so I would hope that because you think for yourselves, as I look down this line, that you are independent and you think for yourself, that you stay that way. That you know what's good and going to keep you safe. And I also feel like you have a bit of a responsibility to make sure you do that for your friends as well. So you, your friends and you have a job to keep one another out of trouble. So congratulations. I so appreciate that you have taught your children to think independently and do what's right. How about a huge round of applause? Congratulations, parents, on that success. I don't know how I got one right and the other one, we just missed the boat. I must have been tired.